Hello everyone, so welcome back to this channel once again after a very long time. So this time I'm here with all of you to present this topic, that is a space before keyword in printer 5 and IBM AS400. So I'll be presenting these such topics within this, related to this space B keyword. So first thing is introduction to space B keyword in printer 5. So space B is basically the space before keyword that is used with the printer 5s in IBMI, and the syntax is space B and then the space before value, and this value could range from 0 to 255, up to 255. So we can use this either at the record level or at the individual field level of the record formats. So at both level we can use this. And one most important thing here is, if you specify the line numbers in the printer 5, you cannot use this keyword. So you'll be getting the compile time at that time. So with the specified line numbers, we cannot use the space B keyword or the space A keyword or any other printer 5 keyword like skip B or skip A, which I'll be covering later. Now, that's what the space B keyword is doing. Its main work is to giving a space with the number of lines which has been specified as a space before value. So if I specify 2, space B 2, then it will specify, it will give the 2 lines spacing, and then will print whatever the record formats. If it is specified the record format, so basically all the fields of the record formats, or it will print that field after specifying that particular spacing if it is specified on the field. So that's what it is doing. Now I'll move to the second point, that is using a space B keyword at record level. So let me show you example that will let you know how I'll do this. So this is an external printer file where you can see I have defined 3 head record formats: header, detail and footer. And I'm using a space B keyword with the header record format and the detail record format. So you can see I did not specify the line numbers, because as I already told, we cannot use a line, we cannot specify line numbers if we are using the space B keyword. Or we cannot specify, or you can say we cannot specify space B keyword if we are specifying the line numbers. So now it will start from the 5th position, that is the starting position, and then will print field 1, and then will give next 5 positions spacing, and then will print this heading. So this way the header or the detail formats would get printed, and then at last the footer will be printed. Now you can see space B is specified with these 2 at the record format level. So what it will do, it will start printing the all the fields of this header record format as after specifying 2 lines of spacing. So basically it will start from third line, so it will skip first and second line by specifying 2 lines spacing, and then will start printing from the third line. The same way it will give 2 line spacing, and then we'll start printing from the 5th line. So that's how it is working. Now next point is RPGLE program to print a file that uses space B keyword at the record format. So before going into that, let me compile this using option 14, or you can run create printer file command as well. So if I'm doing paste down, so these are the important things which you must have to specify: length, lines per page, and width, positions per line, 132. So lines and width have to be defined. So the default is 66 and 132. Also you need to mention the overflow line number. So that's according to your requirement. So I'm going with the default one. So default is 60. Let's create this printer file. So printer file is created. Let me show you the design using option 19. on this. So you can see it skips, it leaves the spaces, and then we'll print the heading, and then we'll leave the space and print the details. And at last, print the footer. So one more important thing is, if you see, this is at the fifth line, that's because it was there on the third line. So if I specify two line spacing, so it will leave the third line, it won't print there, and the fourth line, so it will start from the fifth line. That's what you didn't get confused with this, that it will print from sixth line. So it will always print from the fifth line, because the spacing is of two, and we were at this point, and from here we provide two lines of spacing. Just take F3 to come out. Now the printer file has been compiled. The next point was this one, the record RPGLE program. Let me show you. So this is the RPGLE program, where you can see the printer file PRTF4A is defined in output mode, and that's the printer keyword is specified with this printer file, and we have specified an overflow indicator, so that will get on once the overflow page number reached, that is 60 in our case. So this is used to define the overflow indicator with the printer files, and this is the input file which we will be reading in our program to actually print the retail form. So first thing is to write the header. So that's the first header. Then we'll start reading the physical file. Since it's a keyed file, so we'll be first setting the settle with the star lowel. If it was not a key file, we did the settle with the RRN, that is one, or a specified RRN if you want. So here we set LL star lowel PF1, read the file, and then we will read the file in loop until not percentile end of file condition is. So this is the end of loop. So we will be reading the file in loop here. So you can see read again. So that will be reading in the loop. So this was the first thread, and then read in loop. Now within this loop, what I'll do before printing the detail, I would check if the indicator 01 sets to 1, which means the overflow has been reached. So in that case, we need to print the heading on the next page. We need to skip from here. We don't need to print next lines, and we need to jump to the second page and have to print the header again, so that we can again start printing the details. So we'll write the header. So once it sets to on, what we'll do, we'll set it to off manually. After this, header gets printed. So at the first time, if you see, if I'm at the first page, so at the first time it will not get on, it is not on, and it will print the detail. Okay, so what I'm doing is evaluating the file field to the printer file field and writing the detail format. So it will write let's say until 60, and then once the 60 reached, it will come here, it will check indicator 01 on, then it will jump to the second page, and it will write this header again, and then it will write those 60 records again on second page if they were available on the physical file one. And finally, once all the detailed record formats have been printed, we will write the footer. So that has to be printed the last, and setting the last record indicator to 1. So that's an unnecessary thing. We should avoid this LR on, and that's if not required. So that's the return from the program. Now we will compile this RPGLE program with star source. let's call this program offloading. Just do workshop. This will print the report, field 1, field 2, heading and details. So if I go up and do plus 1, we are on the first line. Oh, sorry. Hey. So you can see on the first page, on the third line, this one gets printed. I do plus 1, you'll see on the first page, fifth line, it gets started printed on one first line, seventh, first page, seventh line, first page, ninth line. So it is giving a two line spacing on every record, gets printed in day, and that's followed. So this is how the SPACEB key will have affected the printer file that has been printed and then spooled output. Now let me show you using SPACEB keyword field level. So that's again the same example, but here this time I use the SPACEB keyword with the field one, so that would again give me the same result. If I would see, let's do 19, so I would see the same thing, the same way the report gets printed. So how can I make it to print it in a changed manner? Let me do that. If I would have used this here, let's say I use this as SPACEB here, so it will print field 1 heading on the first line, and what it will do before printing PU2, it will give a space of two lines. So it will be printed on third line. Okay, and then it will give the same line spacing before printing all the fields of this record format. This way, the output gets affected. So this is on the first line and this is on the third line, as you can see. And this will be on the fifth line as the same. So this was a print of file using SPACEB keyword at field level. Now RPGLE program to print print of file that uses SPACEB keyword at field level. So let me show you that as well. So this one. So nothing changed in this program. This is the same program as RPGLE 4A, which I showed you and explained. The only difference is the defined printer file. So here the defined printer file is PRTF4 instead of PRTF4A. And everything else is same. So let me compile this and call this. So this time you can see PRTF4 gets printed. Okay, I think I did not recompile this printer file because I changed that and it used the existing object. Okay, let's call this. Now you can see on the first line, first page, first line, this got printed. On the first page, third line, this got printed. And on the first page, fifth line, this got printed. First page, seventh line, ninth line, 11th line. So this way, this SPACEB keyword affected the things on the printer file. So, I think I have already shown you the object creation, program execution steps, and browsing the spool file. So that's all in this video. Thank you.